as a kid. All the nigga wanna have was a Burberry scarf and $3 in my pocket. Instead I got beat with a switch, but I don't give a fuck, but it's on my body. Scars all up on me, but I run around from everybody. Life lesson learned, I better learn from this bitch, nobody. She pushed me around, she didn't give no motherfucks about it. She broke my heart 3 times, but I ain't getting...
Last team that we have to talk about for the NFC North are the Minnesota Vikings. Now, the Minnesota Vikings, in my opinion, lost more than any other team in the offseason. They lost Stephon Diggs. They lost Everson Griffin, Xavier Rhodes, Trey Waynes. They lost a lot because they were in cap hell. So they had to get rid of a lot of players. So now, who are going to be the guys who are going to be coming in filling those shoes of the players that they got rid of in the offseason? Now, a few days ago, they recently traded for Yannick Ngakoue with the Jacksonville Jaguars. Now, I think they gave up pretty fair compensation for Yannick Ngakoue. And they're going to be pairing him up with Danielle Hunter, which I think is a pretty good trade. I think pairing him up with Danielle Hunter is going to be pretty good. And I think this is going to be a pretty good pass rushing duo with Danielle Hunter and Yannick Ngakoue. And I think they pretty much upgraded over Everson Griffin. Now, Everson Griffin is still really good, but he's up there in age. So they actually got younger with the addition of Yannick Ngakoue. And on top of that, you still have one of the best linebacker groups in the NFL. You got Anthony Barr, you got Eric Kendricks, who actually played really well last year. I feel like he was one of the best middle linebackers from 2019. And you got Eric Wilson. Then the cornerback position, you got Mike Hughes, who a lot of people in that Minnesota Vikings organization are really excited over. A lot of people feel he can become that next great corner in Minnesota. You also got rookie Jeff Gladney out of TCU. You got Cameron Dantzler, who is another rookie out of Mississippi State University, I believe. So you got a lot of young players that are going to be playing in the secondary for the Minnesota Vikings. You also got Harrison Smith and Anthony Harris, who Anthony Harris is playing, looking to get a new contract. So Anthony Harris is a guy who a lot of people didn't really know all that much about. Like, we only knew about Harrison Smith. Well, we didn't really know how good Anthony Harris was until free agency came around. A lot of teams were jumping at the bit trying to get him. So the Minnesota Vikings were able to secure him for at least one more year, I believe. So they got a pretty good defense still. Now, offensively, I still think they're really good as well, despite the fact that they lost Stephon Diggs. They're going to be replacing Stephon Diggs with Justin Jefferson, which I believe is a little bit of an upgrade, because although Justin Jefferson isn't as good as Stephon Diggs, he's cheaper. You don't have to pay that big contract that Stephon Diggs was going to demand for. So you trade him to the Buffalo Bills. So now you got Justin Jefferson coming in, and you still have a pretty good 1-2 punch at the wide receiver position. If Justin Jefferson is as good as we believe that he is, you want to be pairing him up with Adam Thielen. So, I mean, you still got a pretty good wide receiver duo, in my opinion. And the tight end group, you got Irv Smith, you got Kyle Rudolph there. And the offensive line is a little bit of a question mark. A lot of people are worried about the offensive line, but I think the offensive line shouldn't be all that terrible. I think it should be at least average at best. And you got Kirk Cousins at quarterback. Now, Kirk Cousins surprised he didn't surprise a lot of people. We were expecting Kirk Cousins to play up to the level of that contract, because he was getting $88 million guaranteed with that contract that he signed the Minnesota Vikings in free agency a few years back. So, I mean, we expected Kirk Cousins to play this well, but he was finally able to show up when it mattered the most in prime time, in the playoffs versus the New Orleans Saints, because a lot of people didn't believe that the Minnesota Vikings could go on the road in New Orleans and get that victory there, but they were able to do that. So, I mean, Kirk Cousins actually showed that he was worth that $88 million guaranteed, but that was last year. That was 2019. Now, this is a new season. Kirk Cousins have to be able to keep up that level of play. And you also got offensive coordinator Gary Kubiak, who is going to be taking over for Kevin Stefanski, who left for Cleveland to take their head coaching job there. And Gary Kubiak is one of the best offensive minds in the NFL, probably one of the best offensive coordinators in NFL history. So, I mean, I don't think the Minnesota Vikings are going to have a drop-off too bad in offensively. I really think they could be a little bit better offensively than what they were last year. Now, this is a run-first team with Dalvin Cook. You also got Alexander Mattison there. Now, Dalvin Cook is also looking to get paid as well. And here's the thing. I got no problem with the Minnesota Vikings paying Dalvin Cook, but here's my thing. I want to wait to see if Dalvin Cook can actually stay healthy before I go ahead and dish out that kind of money to Dalvin Cook. Now, good thing is that if the Minnesota Vikings can't get a deal done with Dalvin Cook, you got Alexander Mattison to fall back on. And Alexander Mattison is basically Dalvin Cook 2.0. He's just a little bit more heavier and weight and doesn't really have all that much experience as Dalvin Cook has. But, I mean, Alexander Mattison is like Dalvin Cook 2.0. So, if the Minnesota Vikings can't get something worked out long-term with Dalvin Cook, I think Alexander Mattison would be the perfect replacement for him. Now, this division is really tough because you got the Green Bay Packers, who are the reigning division champions. You got the Detroit Lions, which I think the Detroit Lions are a really interesting team because they got a lot of talent. It's just all about can they put that talent together, and is Matt Patricia the right coach to get them to the playoffs? You also got the Chicago Bears, which they went 8-8 last year. If Nick Foles is, you know, the quarterback that we believe that he is and is an upgrade over Mitchell Trubisky, then Chicago Bears are also a playoff contender as well. So, I mean, this NFC North division is really tough. So, where do the Minnesota Vikings lie in the NFC North hierarchy? Well, I still think that they are the second best team in the division behind the Green Bay Packers. You got Mike Zimmer, who is still one of the better coaches in the NFL. My thing with the Minnesota Vikings is that the Minnesota Vikings aren't really consistent. Like, 1 year they make it to the playoffs, the next year they miss the playoffs, then the following year they make it back to the playoffs. So, I mean, can they repeat and make it back to the playoffs this year? Now, like I said earlier, they did lose a lot, but they also brought in younger players as well, which is going to help them out cap-wise. And also Kirk Cousins. I mean, is he going to be able to keep up the season that he had in 2019? Is his hot streak going to carry over into 2020? That remains to be seen, but I still think the Minnesota Vikings are a really good team. And, I mean, Justin Jefferson, man, I think Justin Jefferson is going to be the best rookie wide receiver right away because he's going to have to contribute because when Adam Thielen is going to be getting all the attention on defenses and Adam Thielen is going to be commanding double teams, that's going to open up opportunities for Justin Jefferson. Also, Irv Smith is a guy who a lot of people aren't really talking about. I think that Irv Smith could have a breakout season for the Minnesota Vikings. Now, Kyle Rudolph is still there. He's still lingering there, but I think that Kyle Rudolph is playing on his last leg. I don't really think that Kyle Rudolph doesn't really have that many years left. I think he's kind of regressing, really. I think he's just a really good red zone target, but overall, I think we should start to see Irv Smith become a breakout player in the NFL this season. He should have a pretty big role in this Minnesota Vikings offense in 2020. Now, when I did my record prediction for the Minnesota Vikings, I had them going 7-9. I actually think now with the addition of Yannick Ngakoue and what I've been hearing from training camp, I actually think they could go 9-7, 10-6. It's just that this division is so tough and they have a pretty difficult schedule, in my opinion, this season. But I think the Minnesota Vikings do have a good chance of making it back to the playoffs. It's all about how well Kirk Cousins performs. Can he keep up that hot streak that he had in 2019? Would that be able to carry over in 2020? I also want to see what Gary Kubiak brings to this Minnesota Vikings offense, because his offense was pretty good last year. What additional wrinkles is he going to add to this offense? And like I said, I don't think this offensive line is going to be as bad as some people think that it will be. I like Ezra Cleveland, who they drafted out of Boise State. I think he was one of the best offensive tackles coming out of the 2020 NFL draft. So, I mean, although the Minnesota Vikings, they lost a lot, they brought in younger players, which is going to help them out a lot. The question is, how long is it going to take these younger players with a shortened offseason, a shortened training camp to get acclimated to the NFL game? That remains to be the question. So, every